You gentlemen will of course be acting upon your oaths today, won't you? Because I hereby accept your oath of office.
Who's in charge here?
Sergeant's just walking down here.
That's the sergeant.
What you guys should be thinking about is one of these days it's going to be coming to you, because they want to lay you lot off. Well, the good ones anyway. They don't mind the bully boy ones.
Right then, you know what's going off. Text chaps, do you want to take my picture now? You've had it often enough. Is Mr. K about? And how are you, Mr. K? Are we going on any window ledges today? That I have to drag you off again? Right, are you the security?
Yes.
I take it you read that.
No, don't.
Because
don't
when you've read that, when you've read that, you won't
we've
be working as a security man anymore.
Yes,
because criminal act.
He employed has. And read the notice, please.
Criminal act. You will be committing a criminal
act
if you obstruct me in the pursuance of my... Yes, Mr. K.
Can I just put you on notice before we go any further?
What's that, Mr. K?
Oh,
I don't.
Criminal act.
That means absolutely nothing to me. It didn't mean nothing at Exeter Road.
It's not a criminal act. It's not a criminal act. It's a civil matter.
This is a civil matter.
That's why
I'm reading that.
Right.
No.
You're not allowed to.
It didn't work at Exeter Road, Mr. K. It didn't work at Stale Street.
This is 70 Road, Rutter Road. This is not Alberton
Street. Bits of paper
don't bother me. I've got to do my.
I am not trespassing. You are trespassing. Does that mean you don't do his job?
Yeah.
Who's in charge? And right. Who's in charge?
I am.
Who's in charge? Which police officer is in charge?
Sergeant.
Sergeant, could you take a couple of distances?
No. You've seen a copy.
Oh, so you're playing that old game. You don't show us the warrant.
I can show you the warrant.
Officer is denying there's his paperwork.
There's the warrant. There's the warrant. You don't need to touch
officer,
it. You can
you've seen
read.
This.
Do you need glasses?
Show us the valid paperwork.
Glasses so you can read it. There's the valid paperwork.
Officer.
There's the valid paperwork.
Right. Show us the signature on it,
right.
Please.
Right, there's the card court stamp there. Nottingham card court stamp. Don't need the signature from me. We'll have the signature.
And the value. The value being claimed, please.
No, we're not going through.
Please show us the value being claimed. Officer, no. You've seen him denying his access to the information.
The refuses paperwork. They are.
We want to see the paperwork.
Security officers.
He's only shown us the front of the paperwork. We want to see the rest of it.
You've read
denied us access to the paper. We can't let you in.
You've read this. If anybody obstructs,
you're on notice, David, and the rest of you, that you're not being allowed access here today.
They are guilty of a criminal
offence. Any use of violence, and you'll be found guilty of a criminal offence.
Are you refusing me entrance to this premises?
Your entrance has been
Are you refusing an officer of court entrance to these premises?
You personally
Fisher and Lightwood. But you haven't got any power of arrest.
Oh, yes.
Fisher and Lightwood, law of mortgages,
can you give it
taking
again?
Peaceful possession. If physical possession is to be taken, it must be taken peacefully. If violence is used to secure entry, the mortgagee may be liable to prosecution under the criminal law. Although the mortgagor will not have no civil remedy against the mortgagee,
that you're obstructing us.
Violence need not be against a person, but may also be in the manner of entry, such as breaking open doors of the house. Consequently, save where the mortgagee consents to the mortgagee taking actual possession, which will be rare, the occasions where a physical taking of possession is possible will be rare. It will generally only be possible if the mortgager and any tenant of the mortgager has abandoned the premises. Fishers and Lightwood, Law of Mortgages, 13th edition, paragraph 588, paragraph 29. I'm not Mr. Fergus, no.
Well, you've been to court.
Number 29.
And
there
orders,
is an appeal.
Orders.
There's an appeal.
There's an appeal.
There's an appeal lodged at the Court of Appeal, of course.
And
that's
where
the
is
Room
it?
Of Appeal.
Is, where
in
is
London.
It? Has it been done?
In London.
Has it been
it's
done?
Been fouled.
Has it been fouled?
It's been processed.
Has it
that's
been
all
done?
You need to know. No, it's been processed.
No.
Excuse me, please.
That's breach of the peace.
Don't assault me.
It's breach of the peace.
please.
Yes. It's breach of the peace.
You're breaking the law.
That's breach of the peace. You're breaching the peace.
You won't be working as a security officer after today.
You're breaching the peace. And you're making friends.
You'll have you arrested.
And you're making
and
friends.
And you won't work as a security officer again.
You're making friends.
Because your license will be revoked.
You're shaking. Stop shaking on my arm.
Shaking.
Right.
Right.
You're breaking the law.
Are you listening? You won't be
you're breaking the law.
After today, if I have you arrested,
are you dead?
Not be working. Your life.
You're breaking the law. You won't be working next week. You won't be working.
All right,
you may be working next week, but you won't be working this time next year. I guarantee
hey,
that.
Next year.
This time next year, you won't. Whoa, that's why you
yeah,
don't care.
To a prison
you?
Cell where you belong.
That's why you don't care. That's why you don't care about the law.
I do care.
You've been breaking the law
for so long.
You're impervious to it. You think you make the law, don't you?
Oh no,
you're not a law abider. You're not a law abider.
I just do.
You
the
think
law.
You make the
no,
law?
Not
but
law.
Parliament has supremacy of the law in this country.
Rubbish.
Not bailiffs.
You have been through the court process.
Not bailiffs. You
have
are a
been
civil
through
servant.
The legal process.
You're civil servant. You're civil servant. You're a civil servant. Servant, right? You're a servant of the people.
You've been to the court.
A single judge.
A judge.
The appeal process has not been exhausted.
You haven't made an appeal.
Oh.
You haven't made one. You've shown me the court, High Court order that says I shouldn't do this.
It doesn't have to be an order. It takes time to process. I have appealed.
You haven't appealed it. You've shown me you've appealed it to the High Court and where the High Court has got the appeal.
This one here.
You go and check with them. You go and check with
them. I'm shoot down the
one.
No,
you go on the phone. Do your job. Do your job and get on the phone.
I spoke to the judge this morning. Judge Ingalls.
I love
this.
The real appeal over here is to the High Court. It's to the Court of Appeal.
He's told you to go ahead.
Judge Ingalls has told me to go ahead.
Where's it in your
going to
see?
Nuremberg trials, mate.
Oh, dear, dear.
Yeah, oh, dear. It's the truth. It's law. I'll do what I'm told.
Yeah, right. So I take it we're not going then?
No.
Right, what are we off? On
here
we
go.
I've got a warrant.
Yeah. Property. These people are obstructing us of the court in the presence of his duty.
Lawfully, we're offering lawful resistance.
Yeah. Under Section 10 of the Criminal Justice Act 1977.
No, you can't do that, I guess.
You can't.
We're not squatting.
We're not squatting. We're not squatting.
You can't do that.
People will be arrested.
We're not squatting.
Prevent this gentleman from entering this property.
Under what law? Under what law? Are we squatters? Are we squatters?
So start
are we squatters?
Are we squatters?
Are we squatters? Are we squatters?
We're either going to let these people enter, you've had your say, or I'm going to start with arresting. Everybody here will get arrested.
And we'll be taking out private prosecutions. We'll be
it seems to me you're aiding and abetting in an unlawful
offense.
Act.
A criminal offence.
He's not available to you on this particular occasion, sir.
But what I'm going to do,
Fisher and Lightwood's Law of Mortgages, 13th edition, page 588, paragraph 29.9, right? I'm serving notice to, what's his name, Sergeant?
Harding.
Sergeant Harding. I'm serving notice to Sergeant Harding, but if he uses any force or intervenes in something that is in effect a civil matter, he will be committing a criminal offence, and we will be bringing, if necessary, private prosecutions against him and his chief constable.
Section 10.
And who's this gentleman?
David Koresh.
Yeah. David Koresh, where's your EX 96?
Section 10.
It's unlawful.
I've got
right,
the warrant.
See, where's
I've
the EX 96? Can we see it? Can we see
it? I've seen it, Mr.
Koresh. No,
I'm
Joseph Fergus.
You just lied to me, said you weren't.
I didn't lie to you.
You said, was he Mr. Joseph Fergus?
You said, if I'm Mr., I'm not a Mr. I'm not a Mr.
So you're Mr. Fergus?
No, I just told you I'm not a Mr. I've just told you. Don't
have no right.
That's assault.
You
right.
have no right.
Don't put your hands on me. Let's see the EX96.
You're a bankrupt.
Let's see the EX96. Where's my bankruptcy? Where's the bankruptcy?
And you have
where's
no the right to this property.
You're an uneducated man, obviously. You're an uneducated man. You are uneducated man.
I've seen more life than you.
You're an uneducated man. What side of life have you seen now? The gutter. The gutter end. In the gutter end. Right? Taking peaceful possession. Fisher and Lightwood. Fisher and Lightwood. I mean, let me know something. Fisher and Lightwood, if you speak to Mike. Fisher and Lightwood, Law and Mortgages, 13th edition. Page 588, paragraph 29.9. Taking peaceful possession. If physical possession is to be taken, it must be taken peacefully. If violence is used to secure entry, the mortgagee may be liable to prosecution under the criminal law. Although the mortgager would have no civil remedy against the mortgagee, violence need not only be used against the person, but also in the manner of entry, as by breaking open doors of the house. Consequently, save where the mortgager consents to the mortgagee taking actual possession, which would be rare, the occasions where a physical taking of possession is possible would be rare. It will generally only be possible where the mortgager and any tenants of the mortgager.
And then I screwed you over.
Section 10 doesn't apply for any arrest today. Have you got the Section 10 part? You need to read Section 10 out because it doesn't apply. Section 10 on the back of the
Section
10. Right. Can I have a quick word?
Yeah?
Yeah, go. We are providing this.
The use of force under Section 10 of the Criminal Law Act 1997 does not apply because the proprietor or other authorised occupies or someone is present on the premises where no one is squatting. Section 10 doesn't apply, so it will be an unlawful arrest and you will be acting outside of everyone's office.
I think in the light of that information, you could do with taking advice from someone back.
You need to be going back.
Call Malcolm Turner for advice, sir.
You need to be going back to Chief Constable Chris Eyre. You need to be going back to Chief Constable Chris Eyre. This notice has been served on Constable Chris Eyre.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
If any constable lays hands on me, it'd be assault.
And we will follow the assault charges up on all of you.
I'm peacefully here on a friend's property. And Section 10 doesn't apply to me.
Friend's property doesn't. So you
haven't carried out this
LPA
conviction.
Receivers property. So you're a big friend of the LPA receivers.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I'll have to ring them up.
Yeah, but if you have a look at the LPA receivers paperwork, it says Mr. Fergus versus Mr. Fergus.
Sergeant, I think you need to get in touch with the legal department.
He's down there.
What's he doing?
He's gone down there. In the front.
Nobody's actually causing a breach of the peace here today, except for the bailiff. So Section 10 doesn't apply. Any arrest under Section 10 is a void act, is an unlawful act, and which is outside of the constable's office, where you'll all be personally liable.
Personally liable.
Yeah, sure, mate. Probably not supposed to be in the elbow anyway.
civil matter and the cops are not supposed to be here for at least 50 minutes today.
Well, as long as they act lawfully, then they'll be acting correctly on YouTube. If they act unlawfully, that's a different matter. And all members of the public will get to see how you all act. And hopefully it will be lawfully.
No man can assume the benefits of the law, right, by refusing to accept the burdens of the law. So it doesn't matter whether you're a judge or whether you're a police officer or whether you're a court bailiff. You're still subject to the law, right? The law still binds you. And nobody can give you immunity from the law.
David Rees. That guy in the dead glove jacket, I don't know who he is. I
think you can get that out of my face.
It's not in your face.
Mark, just come back onto the property.
David? David? Hi.
Hi.
Can we have your name, please?
Yes, Brian.
Brian what?
B-U-S-B-U-I.
B-U-S-B-U-I, thank you. And who are you representing today, Brian?
Of course.
In what capacity?
Bailiff.
Oh, you are a bailiff, then? And do you get this about us objecting to the use of violence to get an entry? You with that?
Nobody's used any violence.
No,
so
the violence, you know. Using the police, for instance, to batter down the door.
Go and talk to your mates.
Well, step away if you don't like it.
How you doing?
Brian, I don't want you to break the law today. David, same with you.
I think the truth hurts.
You both know that we're peaceful guys anyway, that there's not going to be any breach of the peace. In spite of this extreme provocation
even,
of the likes
I'm
of David...
I'm not even going to go there.
In spite of David Caress's attempts to provoke it.
Well, actually, there's something you can use for that. It's called Grey-Ban. You spray it on your hair and just comb it through, and it puts melanin back into your hair and it returns to 90% of its natural colour. Well, I didn't have much, apart from I did have a lot of grey down here, and I used that stuff, and now I've let my hair grow because it's... It's there.
Hello, what stuff do you?
Grey-Ban.
Grey-Ban.
Yeah, it's not a dye or anything. You just it's twice a week. You just spray your hair, just comb it in. That's it. Job done. I bet you're getting more like this, aren't you?